The Australian Maltese Chamber of Commerce welcomes new members. For more details, visit their website, amcc.org.au.
Jiena Marlene Scicluna inselmilkomu nilqakom fil-programm Maltese Down Under, programm bi produzzjoni mill-Belt ta' Melbourne. Illum ser nitkellmu ma' l-istilista magħruf Jason Grech, ser nlaqgħukom ukoll ma' Steve u Martha Varga li jirrappreżentaw lill-Malta f'kompetizzjonijiet internazzjonali. U fl-aħħar nett nitkellmu ma' Father Robert Gallia, saċerdot żagħżugħ li qed jagħmel isem fix-xena mużikali. L-ewwel taqsima tagħna llum ser toħodna fl-istudio tal-istilista magħruf Jason Grech.
So tell us more about how you started in designing. Were you always wanting to be in this industry?
Not really, no. Well, I did start up probably about 16 years ago. Mm-hmm. Wanted to do something which was a bit more creative. I did start off as an apprentice chef, and that was all, yeah, that was awesome, but it was a bit harder.
Did you say chef?
Yeah, I was an apprentice chef. And then I studied accounting for 2 years, and that was a bit sterile, I thought. Then, yeah, moved into design, which has been really awesome and really easy.
What inspires you in your designs? You've got such incredible designs, Jason. I mean, your designs have graced some of the top stars in Australia and even in America. What inspires you when you come to just sit down and think, okay, this is what's coming out today?
So I look at things like colours, I look at things like architecture, I look at things like materials which are available, and then I sort of set themes. So it could be just a girl on the street, it could be something like the Chrysler Building or the Melbourne Town Hall, sort of starts there, yeah, and then just moves on.
And what about the colours? You know how every year there are colours that come out and they're the colours in fashion.
Yes.
Do you go by that or you just disregard that completely and then...
We disregard it completely.
Disregard it.
Yeah, it's just easier doing it like that. We just think it's easier to be one of the leaders rather than to follow trends. So it's easier that way.
That's great. Now, we have mentioned that your designs have graced quite a few stars. Do you want to run us down maybe a few of the stars that have worn Jason Grech?
Sure. We've been really successful and we're, you know, really thankful. And we dress people like Delta, we've done Kelly Osbourne, we've dressed Danny Minogue, so lots of, you know, really awesome artists that, you know, work hard.
So do they come in with an idea already, or do they just leave it up to you?
It depends with Danny. Her stylist normally comes up with a theme, and then we workshop that, or he may call and say, we're after something for X Factor, and it's Rock Week, and then we just design something which is a bit more hard, lots of rock and lots of, you know, hardware. And when I met Kelly Osbourne, she was really easy and really amazing. Hers was just, you can design what you're after. Uh-huh. It just depends on
the person.
Yeah, on the person, really.
You also do wedding dresses, and you had, for a while, you had Jason Grech White.
Yes.
Which now is all combined under the Jason Grech umbrellas.
Yes.
Tell us more how you started Jason Grech White.
Okay, so we started up with Jason Grech, and that was just a really nice evening brand. Mm-hmm. And then we did one wedding gown, which became two, which became five, which became 10, which became 30. And then it was really hard to, what we did not want was to confuse our customers.
Yeah.
So we thought, let's just, you know, just add Jason Grech White. And we, I had that for about 6 years, and then I just decided to merge them. And once that's done, it's just made it much easier in terms of Facebook, the website. And what we thought would confuse them, having one, doesn't. which has been good.
We're actually standing in front of a few of your dresses, and what really stands out, Jason, is that they're not your normal or, you know, popular wedding dress. They're so different to what we would think of a wedding dress, aren't they?
Yes, they are. We just think it's easier to design something that has a niche. You know, we look at brides, or I look at them and think, if I was a bride, what do I want to look like?
You want to stand
out. Not that I'll ever be one or wear a gown. But you have
to be in that mindset.
You have to be in that mindset. And we find out customer comes to us because they're after something a bit more different.
Yeah. And your name has also been linked to the Melbourne Spring Carnival.
Yes.
You have also been the face, your designs have also been the face of the Melbourne Spring Carnival a few years back.
Yes.
Tell us more about your involvement in the Melbourne Spring Carnival. And obviously every year you always have a model that competes as well.
Yes. So when I started, it was 2003. Now I'm feeling old, but it was 2003. And we just, entered a racing design comp. We were probably in business about 6 months or so, and we won that. So what that did was just really propel us to become a racing brand. We then did, you know, we've won second twice, and we've been, I think, in the top five about four, happy about that. So yeah, and we dress lots of jockeys' wives, lots of trainers' wives.
About your Maltese background. Obviously, with a surname like Grech, are Maltese.
You like Smith, really?
So tell us about your story of your parents' migration to Australia.
So my parents came over in 1973, and I've got 10 siblings. I've got 6 brothers and 4 sisters.
They were quite busy, weren't they?
Mm-hmm. Very good Catholic people. And, you know, and yeah, they've all been really amazing. The last one, so I was born in Australia and the others overseas.
You're the baby.
I'm the baby, as they say, yes. The last one. The golden child, as I like to think about it. My siblings probably won't say so. Yes, they do. They're awesome, you know. And coming from a big family is really amazing because the support group's always there.
Yeah.
And, you know, really careful being wogs, as we can say. Because we are some.
It's very fashionable to be a wog as well.
Yeah. Yes. You know, it's just been really good because I've got that really good grounding, which I'm thankful for.